Lighting in agriculture is a major energy cost, especially for enclosed production operations. Updating to LED lighting is one of the largest potential energy savings for farm operations. It can also improve production, worker safety, and the overall well-being of plants and animals.
We are a commercial turkey operation, a grower for Michigan turkey producers in West Michigan. We start around 700,000 tom turkeys annually. We grow them to an age of approximately 19 to 20 weeks, and hopefully they leave our facility at about 45 pounds when they go to market. We have tried to be on what we like to think is the cutting edge of energy efficiency in West Michigan. LED lighting is the primary thing that got us involved. We want to reduce our lighting load by about 50% overall, so we're getting close.
LED stands for light emitting diode, and it's a light with a much longer lifespan than other types of lighting.
LED lighting was one of the best things to start with. It was very cheap to do, and you get a lot of bang for your buck. We have LED tubes like you use in your old fluorescent style bulbs, and then we have also screw-in LED bulbs.
LEDs can be configured to produce any color of the rainbow. However, the more common color classifications are warm white, cool white, and daylight, which are determined by their color temperature measured in Kelvin. White light is about 5,000 Kelvin, which is the color temperature of light from the sun at noon on a cloudless day. Unlike other lamps, switching an LED light off and on does not reduce its lifespan. An LED will lose some of its lumen output over time, though less than other types of lamps. And as it nears the end of its life, an LED's color output will shift to a warmer, slightly yellowish color temperature. Agricultural operations often provide the toughest environment for LED lamps and their circuitry, subjecting them to a mixture of high moisture and humidity, excessive dirt and dust, extreme temperature variations, vibration and shaking from machinery or animals, as well as voltage fluctuations, conditions that will more quickly deteriorate lumen output and reduce the lamp's lifespan. So farmers should use commercial-grade LED fixtures and lamps that can effectively operate under harsh conditions. And commercial-grade fixtures will also hold up to being cleaned. This is important because dirt that accumulates not only reduces illumination, but acts as insulation, increasing fixture heat and reducing bulb life. A study by the Department of Energy determined that after 7,000 hours of operation, LED lamps on outdoor poles decreased illumination by an average of 34%.
We also wanted a spray down rated fixture. The environment's really harsh. So this fixture, I can directly spray it. It can handle the dust, it can handle the dirt. They've actually held up quite well. We've only had probably less than 2 to 3% failure in all the fixtures we've put in.
Installing and testing a couple of lights before purchasing for the whole facility is also a good way to determine which are most resistant to vibration and shaking from machinery, equipment, or jostling by large animals.
We tried probably half a dozen different fixtures before we picked the one that we went with. So there were quite a few different criteria we went with, but we narrowed it down to this one. We're pretty happy with it.
And make sure the LEDs selected can function properly under extreme temperatures.
LEDs kind of have a tendency to like the cold weather better. You turn them on and they're bright right now.
Farms typically run large electric motors and are often located far down the line of electrical distribution networks. This can expose agricultural operations to large voltage fluctuations that negatively impact LED's electronic circuitry, reducing lifespan and increasing the likelihood of failure. Check the manufacturer's technical specifications to identify the lamp's operating voltage range above and below the normal 110 to 120 volt level. The wider the range, the more tolerant the lamp will be to voltage fluctuations. By choosing the right color temperature for your LEDs, you can increase productivity, whether it be for improving plant growth, or increasing milk production, or promoting beneficial animal behavior. Later videos in this series will explore these opportunities in greater detail. In purchasing LED lamps and fixtures, These two logos should be displayed in the technical specifications on the packaging. The UL, or Underwriters Laboratory logo, and the DLC, or Design Lights Consortium logo. The UL listing certifies LED lamps for their safety of operation. Check the specs for information on the lamp's capability to operate under dry, damp, or wet environments. DLC listed lighting products come with a 5-year minimum warranty, an independent safety certification, and are tested to show lumen output per watt and lumen maintenance of 40 to 50,000 hours. Your utility provider will have a list of DLC LED lighting products that qualify for rebates.
For selecting LEDs, I believe the longevity is important. From what we've seen in 5 years, we've never had a bulb fail on its own, ever. I mean, just the energy savings plus the cleanness of the light. LEDs are clean. The light itself is something that pleased my eye. You know, if it pleases me, I'm hoping that it pleases the cows, and I think it does.
Selecting LED lighting in agriculture has potentially large benefits for improving energy efficiency, working environment, safety, and production that can lead to greater profits and a smaller greenhouse gas footprint. It is important to select the right LEDs for your operations. Lighting is often a major long-term investment, so don't hesitate to ask for assistance from agricultural lighting experts in your state.